In this video, we're looking at a kinematics graph problem, and this one is especially tricky. We're given an acceleration time graph. So we can see for the particle that we're describing here, for the first 3 seconds, the acceleration is zero. Then the acceleration jumps up to 3 meters per second squared for 2 seconds, and then back down to zero for the final 2 seconds. We're told in the problem that we can trust the grid spacing, so each vertical space is 1 meter per second squared, each horizontal space is 1 second. And we're given an initial velocity for this particle of 5 meters per second at t equals zero. In part A, we're asked to compute the change in velocity during the acceleration phase, where the acceleration is 3 meters per second squared. That's the easy part. In part B, we're asked to compute the total displacement for this particle for the entire process. And that's the tricky part. So first we'll do part A. I want the change in velocity from t equals 3 to t equals 5 seconds. And you might remember this is just the area bounded by the acceleration time graph. And the bounded area here has a height of 3 meters per second squared. Keeping the units is instructive. And the width is 2 seconds. And I can see that one factor of seconds cancels. And I get a change in velocity of 6 meters per second. Now, because that acceleration is constant, it's easy to look at the math behind this. So as an alternative solution, I could say the acceleration is the change in velocity over the change in time, which means the change in velocity is just that constant acceleration multiplied by how long it lasted, that's delta t. And again, I get 3 meters per second squared, multiplying 2 seconds of time, and I arrive at the same answer of 6 meters per second. Okay, so we know we have a change in velocity of positive 6 meters per second on that short time interval of 2 seconds in the middle of the process. In part B, I want to get the total displacement from t equals 0 to t equals 7. And because my acceleration changes twice, we need to break this into 3 parts. I want to have the first 3 seconds. And in the first 3 seconds, A was equal to 0. That means we're looking at a constant velocity problem. V was 5 meters per second. So all I have to do to get the displacement there, I'll call it delta x, is just take the speed times the time. So 5 meters per second times 3 seconds. Next, we look at the time interval where the acceleration was constant. That happened from 3 to 5 seconds. Now we have a constant acceleration kinematics problem. The acceleration is a constant 3 meters per second squared, and we know the initial velocity here was 5 meters per second, and we know the acceleration lasts for 2 seconds. So this time we have to use a constant acceleration kinematics formula, and I can write it this way. The change in position is given by V naught t plus 1/2 at squared. So we plug in V naught, that was 5 meters per second. The amount of time this lasts for, that's 2 seconds. And plus a 1/2 times A, which was 3 meters per second squared, times T, that's 2 squared. And this gives me a displacement of 16 meters during the second part of the process. Now finally, we look at the time 5 seconds to 7 seconds. And again, because the acceleration is 0, we're looking at a constant velocity part of the problem. But the velocity is now bigger than it used to be. Back in part A, we figured out it grows by 6 meters per second during the acceleration phase. That means our velocity is now 11 meters per second. It stays constant at 11 for the last 2 seconds. So our change in position here is just speed times time because there's no acceleration. That's 11 meters per second times 2 seconds, giving me a displacement of 22 meters on that time interval. Now all we have to do is add them up. In the first 3 seconds, I had a displacement of 15 meters. During the acceleration phase, a displacement of 16 meters. And during the coasting phase at the end, at the higher rate of speed, 22 meters. Adding up all the displacements, we get 53 meters. And that's it. If you enjoyed this video, or at least found it useful, check out another one by clicking one of the links on the left, or click the Zach's Lab logo on the right to explore dozens of physics and math playlists. As always, you can leave your questions, comments, and requests in the comments section below, and I'll get back to you within 24 hours. Thanks for watching Zach's Lab. And best of luck on your math and physics journey.